don't miss any content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Guys, welcome back to Sahara Football. So it's that time of the month again, just 1 month on from when Sike Akono named his squad ahead of that friendly game with Mali and Qatar. And the Black Stars have now named their squad, which is going to face Sudan in that double header. It's quite an interesting squad here, but not much difference from the squad that faced Qatar and Mali. Just a few changes in there. Some of the players that underperformed, rightly so, have been removed. But before I get into the squad list, we know some of the Black Stars players, I think seven in total, contracted the coronavirus. And this week, we started hearing news of recoveries from most of them. And there were news also that those that had contracted would be included in the squad, hoping that by the 13th or the 12th of November, when this game will be played, they will be ready to feature. Yesterday, I brought you that breaking news about Jordan Ayew being euphoric. He recently made that switch to Orlando Pirates from Maritzburg. Razak Abolara recently joined Kumasi Asante Kotoko after that amazing performance against the Qatar when the Black Stars won 5-1. He was impressive at the post. Lawrence Atizigi St. Gallen also in there. For the defenders, this is where my first surprise comes in. Abdul Baba Rahman, someone who hasn't kicked the ball in I don't know how long, but Baba Rahman is with Chelsea FC. And I recently brought you that story that Baba Rahman had been relegated to the under 23 side of Chelsea FC, and I'm surprised he got a call up to the Ghana Black Stars. Are we lacking that much in that position? Lumo Agbengeno would have been first choice, but I don't know, probably Lumo couldn't make this. But Baba Rahman has been called up for this position. The fullbacks, left fullback Baba Rahman, Chelsea FC with the under 23 side, mind you. Gideon Mensah is also in there. He recovered in time. Victoria Gemedes. Harrison Afo makes a return back to the Black Stars fold at right back. He plays for Columbus Crew. Bensing Anan, after that impressive performance against Qatar, I think one good turn deserves another, and he got that rightly so. He plays with Zelina FC. Alexander Djiku, Strasbourg, he did well in those two friendlies. One good 10, again, deserves another. And John Boy, this guy has been amazing for Mets. Captain of the side for Mets this season. He has been stoic at the back for Mets this season. And I think it's just right, based on form and performance, that he gets a call up into the Black Stars. And many people have the opinion that John Boy tends to falter at times when he joins the Black Stars. But Sike Akono is keeping faith with him. And with the way he's performing, it's really hard to overlook such things. Nicolas Opoku, Amiens FC, is also in there. Joseph Adu, Celta Vigo, is also in there. He has, I think, recovered in time because he was one of the people that tested positive for coronavirus. Kasim Nuhu Adams did not make this defense. He is no longer in there. I think he hasn't recovered, if I'm not mistaken, because he was part of those that tested positive for COVID. For the midfielders, Thomas Tepate of Arsenal, obviously, is in there. Baba Idrisu is also in there. He plays for RCD Mayoka. He also recovered in time. Mubarak Wakasu, Jiansing Suning. Wakasu, many of you were calling for him to be in there. Wakasu is back in the Black Stars fold. Hope you are excited about that. Emmanuel Lomote also makes a return from the group that were called up for the friendlies for Amiens. For the forwards or wingers, as you'd call it, for the wingers, I'll start with Andre Ayew, plays for Swansea City. He's also in the captain of the Black Stars, obviously. He would be there. Tariq Fosu did well in that second game. He was placed at his favorite position, that was on the wings. Sam Olousu, the game changer for me, he recently joined Al Ahly Jeddah from Al Fahia. He has made the squad also. Jordan Ayew, our striker, is also in there. And Caleb Ekuban of Trabzonspor, I think he has recovered in time. One of the wingers I missed out here is Jeffrey Schlupp. He plays for Crystal Palace. Hopefully this time he'll be in tip-top shape to make the squad for Ghana. And John Aintree, He missed out because of issues with work permit in Turkey that he could not make that friendly. He can make his first appearance for the first time since 2017 for the Ghana Black Stars, and I'm really excited for him on that journey entry there. And surprise, surprise, debutant Jamie Lewe Lenga. He is with Greta Firth. Siki Akono gave explanations as to why he called some of these players, but let's look through and see some of the new faces. Apparently, this Jamie Leweling is the only new face in there. He plays for Greta Firth in Europe, is 19 years of age, born on the 26th of February 2001, and he plays for in the German second Bundesliga with Greta Firth. Siki Akono will give an explanation on him. Let's have a listen now to Siki Akono's explanation for giving call-ups to some of these young players, and some of these players what informed the call-ups for these players.
Baran was once a regular player here. Due to injury, he was taken out. Now he's back, he's fit, he's playing very well. With his team, unfortunately, he's not had a chance to play in the first team. But he's had a couple of friendly matches since August, September, and even lastly October. This recently, 24th October, which he played against Liverpool second team. And these matches, he's played 90 minutes, some are 90 minutes, a lot of 90 minutes, and of course 70 minutes. So we've taken a lot of consideration, looking at our, the fact that we have a little bit of weakness within that area. The fullbacks, I thought it's necessary to bring him to, of course, compete with Gideon on that side. Yeah. On the right side, just recently, this young gentleman, Benson, who did very, very well, but he needs support. He needs the old guys to be around to learn from him, and therefore I thought it's wise to bring no other person than Arisnafo to back him up and, of course, support him. And that is why Arisin is also there. John Boy is, again, an old guy. All this has, again, the fact that we want immediate solutions, and therefore it is needed for us to deal with the experience and those who have had the surroundings before, who've had the experience, they've been around the terrain, they know what it takes to play qualification and all that, and therefore think in it deep wise. I thought wise to bring somebody who is doing well in Europe. People have talked about him, and I think he's necessary. He deserves that chance, and that's why he's here also to support the team. Yeah. For him, I spoke to him when we were going to Antalya. His time is up for him to join us. And I think he received that message in a very good manner. We spoke again, and today he's here again also to support the team with his rich experience. Well, he had a chance to come. He's also been away for some time. But unfortunately, when we were just about to go to Turkey, he got injured, and I think I still want to keep that team. If he's fit and doing well, I think he has a chance of coming to help us. Oh, it's a young man who is now all over the place. A lot of teams are interested in him because of what he's done. He's growing very, very fast. He just got a chance from the second team, and now he's with the team. And he's been a player, I believe, hope for the future. He's one of the guys that we can have. Because he's young, he's 19 years, and he's had a chance to play for the German national team. And so we're looking at how we can also get him on board and also help us in the future. And that is why he's here. He's somebody I believe, if not today, he's going to be the hope for our future. As we speak now, I've fully spoken to him. I've not assured him. I went to Germany to watch him because he was also recommended by our technical director. You know, nobody had an idea. He said, this boy is a guy we have to. And so I went there to see him play. It was not enough, but the two matches that I saw, I think is a good opportunity for him to also come here and showcase his talent. But for me, I believe that he's somebody that we can hope for the future.
So we heard from Siki Akono there. Were you surprised by any of the call-ups? I don't know much about Jamie Leweling, but I'll do my research on him and see what he has to offer for the Black Stars. 19 years of age, both feet, he is good with both feet, and he is someone Siki Akono sees as the future for the Black Stars. We'll see about that when these players come on the board for the games. That's a doubleheader with Sudan. The games will be taking place at the Cape Coast Sports Stadium, the first leg on the 12th of November 2020. The next one, 5 days later, in Khartoum, Sudan, on the 17th of November. But let me know your thoughts in the comments box on this squad. Are you satisfied? What do you know about Jamie? Let me know your thoughts in the comments box. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.